गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ चैप्टर 5, व्हेन पीपल रिबेल। टिल नाउ इन पार्ट 1 वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर एंड व्हाट वर द वेरियस कॉजेस लाइक पॉलिटिकल कॉज, इकोनॉमिक कॉज, सोशल कॉज, रिलीजियस कॉज, मिलिट्री कॉजेस एंड इमीडिएट कॉजेस ऑफ रिवॉल्ट ऑफ 1857। एंड इन सेकेंड पार्ट वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट दैट हाउ the revolt started and how the rebellion or the soldiers or the people related to the revolt started to spread over the area. Now in part 3 we will study about the result of the revolt and why did this revolt fail. So what were the results of the revolt? The British Parliament, it had passed an act in 1858 year, and they had transferred, or the act mentions that the power of East India Company or the power of British East India Company will transfer to the British Crown or the British Queen King, so that the management could be more responsible for regarding the Indian affairs. A member of British cabinet was appointed, as if there was a cabinet, then any member of it would be appointed as the Secretary of the State for India, and he was the person responsible for all matters related to the governing aspect of India. And addition, he was also given a council of ministers who can advise him. Okay, and that council was known as India Council. The Governor General of India was given the title of Viceroy, which means it is the personal representative of the Crown. Here on your screen you can see two different images. It can be termed as the after result of the revolt. Means in both of the images you can see the British army soldiers are giving punishment to the person or to the people who were involved in the revolt. Okay, all the ruling chiefs of the country, means all the ruling kings of the country, they were assured that their territory, means the area on which they were having the rule, it would not get mixed or it would not get annexed or joined in the future. They were allowed to pass on their kingdom. They were allowed to pass their kingdoms to their heirs, means they can declare any person, including their adopted son, as their successor. But this decision has to be made acknowledged, means this kind of decision should be made in known to the British Queen. Okay, the third point, the Indian rulers were hold their kingdom, means they can stay their kingdoms, but they have to work as a subordinate of the British Crown. Fourth, it was decided that the proportion of the Indian soldiers in the army, it would be reduced, and the number of European soldiers would increase. It was also decided that, there was a decision that to recruit or to employ more soldiers from Awadh, Bihar and Central India and South India. And also there were more recruitment or more people were joining army from the Gorkhas, Sikhs and Pathan. Okay. Next, the land and the property of Muslim people, it was confiscated or it was taken under control by the Britishers on a very large scale, and they were treated with suspicion, means they were not treated good, and British thinks that they were responsible for the rebellion or they were responsible for the revolt. Second point, the British decided to respect, means after the revolt of 1857, British came to know that they must respect the local religion and social practice which were happening in India. There were many policies which were made or which were designed to protect landlords and zamindars so that more security can be given to them regarding their land. There was a new phase of history, or the history changes from 1857 year. The revolt, it marked or shows the end of the British East India Company rule, and the British crown or the British king queen, they had took the administration into their hand. Here you can see the image of revolt between the British soldiers and the Indian at some place in India. There was a cabinet rank minister who was known as the Secretary of the State for India. He was the person behind charge of British political affairs in India, and he was answerable or he was responsible to the parliament. There was a governor general under the company, or who works under the company. He became the viceroy of India and he was answerable to the queen. Lord Canning, he was the last governor general under the company. And when the British crown take the control, so the Lord Canning became the first viceroy at Darbar, or the people gathering, which was held in Allahabad, now known as Prayagraj, on 1st November 1858, Lord Canning read the Queen's proclamation or the Queen's message. In appreciation of the loyalty, to promote loyalty or to give reward against the loyalty which was shown by the Indian people or princes during the revolt, the proclamation or the message clearly says that the doctrine of lapse will not come into effect and the Britishers will not annex more territories with them. It was also promised non-interference, means Britishers has also promised that they will not interfere in India's religious and social custom, which says that the British will not longer take interest in any kind of Indian custom and religious reforms. They hope that, means after this decision, Britishers hope that they would able to win the loyalty of the Orthodox people of Indian society. To win means now they have to win the loyalty of zamindars. Now the Britishers have recognized their traditional land rights, means the Britishers have restored the traditional land rights of the zamindars, and they had also gave them many different kind of titles and honors. The Britishers pursued the policy of divide and rule, means Britishers were taking care and they were practicing the policy of divide and rule so that they don't want the revolt to happen again, and it would help or it would prevent the Indians to reunite again. Here you can see one more image of the revolt between the Indians and the Britishers during 1857. Here you can see the loss of lives from both sides. Okay. Results of the revolt. To remove all prospects of revolt means not to take any chance and or not to promote the revolt, the army administration was taken under control by the British. The proportion of European soldiers were increasing as compared to Indian soldiers. Military plannings or strategic plannings and other important military equipment such as artillery and guns, etc. They were placed under the control of European soldiers only and related officers. The British began to recruit, means now Britishers were not recruiting more soldiers from Awadh, Bihar and Madras, and especially from that area where revolt of 1857 occurred. They now recruit, or after the revolt of 1857, the Britishers were recruiting more soldiers from Sikhs, Gorkhas, Pathans, Rajput and Jats. This community remained neutral, or they did not take part against Britishers during the revolt of 1857. Now the question came, why did revolt fail, or what was the reason behind the failure of this big revolt? The revolt failed to spread over the whole of India, and it was remained limited to northern and central India region. The other region, they were completely unaffected, or they were completely unknown from this kind of revolt. Most of the leaders, they did not able to match the dynamic leadership or good leadership of British. The leaders were motivated, means the leaders were taking care of their own personal gain over the love for their motherland. And many of the leaders, they lacked foresight, and they were not in control of themselves, or they were not having good determination for their motherland. The rebels had no, and the main thing is that the rebels, they did not have any centralized system planning or coordination between them, due to which revolt failed. Here you can see the Britishers capturing and killing the persons who were involved in the revolt. The Indians fought with their outfit, and if we compared the weapons of Indians and Britishers, Indians were fighting with outdated weapons as compared to modern weapons of Britishers. There were many sections in Indian population who were friendly during the British rule to Britishers, such as Chiefs of Patiala, Sindhias, Nizam of Hyderabad, Holkers, Rajput Prince and Zamindars, moneylenders and other merchants. They stayed away from the revolt, or either they were friendly to Britishers. The newly educated Indians, they remained unsympathetic, or they were not getting involved in the revolt. Many of the Indians showed compassion or sympathy and goodwill towards the British, and felt that if they worked with Britishers, it would help in developing of Indian as a nation, or India as a nation. So here comes the end of the chapter of When People Rebel. I hope you have understood the video. Listen to the video and read the PDF very carefully, so that you will understand this chapter clearly. Thank you. Have a nice day.